Hey guys, welcome back. Today I'll be discussing about the topic, how do organisms obtain their food? This is from class 10 biology. Let's start with today's topic. Depending on the type of food and the availability of food, organisms can adapt to a range of strategies of food intake and use. Yes, organisms can adapt to a range of strategies of food intake and use depending on the type of food and the availability of food. Some organisms break down the food materials outside the body. Okay, some organisms break down the food materials outside the body and then absorb it. This mode of nutrition is called saprophytic nutrition. Okay, in saprophytic nutrition, organisms break down the food materials outside the body and then absorb it. Okay, for example, mold, yeast, mushrooms, etc., which are called saprophytes. Okay, so these organisms, mold, yeast, mushrooms, these saprophytes, they break down the food materials outside the body and then absorb the food through their body surface. Okay, so through body surface, food materials are absorbed. Through body surface. Okay, so this is how saprophytic nutrition is seen in saprophytes like mold, yeast, mushroom, etc. Okay, now moving to the next. Some other organisms derive nutrition from plants and animals without killing them. So this is called parasitic nutrition. This is called parasitic nutrition. Okay, some organisms derive nutrition from plants or animals without killing them. Okay, and these plants or animals are called host organisms. Okay, so these plants and animals are called host organisms, host plant or host animal. From these host plant or animal, the organisms, they are called parasites. The organisms are called parasites. Okay, so these parasites derive nutrients from host plant or animal. Okay, for example, cuscuta, lice, leeches, tapeworms. Cuscuta is a plant. Okay, so these are the examples for parasites. Okay, I repeat this once again. Some organisms derive nutrition from plants or animals without killing them. So these plants or animals are called host organisms. And the organisms which are deriving the nutrition from these host organisms are called parasites. Okay, and the mode of nutrition is called parasitic mode of nutrition. Okay, now moving to the next. Other organisms take in whole material. So this is nothing but the food material, whole food material, and break it down inside the body. Okay, some organisms, they take the whole food material into the body and break the food material inside their bodies. What can be taken in and broken down depends on the body's design and its function. This is called holozoic nutrition. This is called holozoic nutrition. In this holozoic nutrition, okay, organisms take the whole food material into the body and break the food material inside their bodies. Okay, and this holozoic nutrition is also called animal-like nutrition. Animal-like nutrition. Okay, humans also follow this strategy. Okay, holozoic nutrition. Okay, now moving to the next. Since the food and the way it is obtained differs, okay, the digestive system is also different in various organisms. Important statement for the exams. I repeat this once again. Since the food and the way it is obtained differs, as we discussed, in case of saprophytic nutrition, the food is obtained through body surface from outside. That is, the way of obtaining nutrition is different. Now, in case of parasites, the organisms are deriving the nutrition without killing the host organisms. So, the way of obtaining the nutrition is different in different organisms. Since the food and the way it is obtained is different, the digestive system is also different in various organisms. Let's discuss this concept in detail with the help of some examples like amoeba and paramecium. In single-celled organisms like amoeba, the food may be taken in by the entire surface. But as the complexity of organism increases, different parts become specialized to perform different functions. This is what we call differentiation. Okay, I repeat this once again. Okay, so in complex organisms, different parts become specialized to perform different functions. This process is called differentiation. But in case of single-celled organisms like amoeba, the entire surface of amoeba is taking part in this process of obtaining food materials. Okay, now moving to the next. Here, amoeba takes in food using temporary finger-like extensions called pseudopodia. These pseudopodia are nothing but the false feet. Okay, so these pseudopodia are also called false feet. Okay, so amoeba takes in food using temporary finger-like extensions called pseudopodia or false feet of the cell surface, which fuse over the food particle forming food vacuole. You can see this here in the diagram. These are the pseudopodia. Okay, so these pseudopodia, they are fusing over the food particle. This is a food particle. Okay, so pseudopodia fuse over the food particle, and as a result, it is forming a food vacuole inside the amoeba. Okay, so here, this is the method how the amoeba is taking the food into the cell, that is inside the cell, and this process is called endocytosis. This process is called endocytosis. As the food is taken into the cell, the process is called endocytosis. Endo means into, okay? Cyto is cell. So food is taken into the cell. This process is called endocytosis. Okay? If the solid food materials are taken, then it can be called, okay, now phagocytosis. It can be called phagocytosis. If the solid food materials are ingested, if the solid food materials are ingested, then the method is called phagocytosis. Okay? Now, if it is a liquid food material, then it is called pinocytosis. Pinocytosis. So this is about the liquid. This is about the liquid food. Okay? So here, with the help of pseudopodia, amoeba is ingesting the food, that is taking the food into the cell, and consequently it is also forming a food vacuole inside the cell. Okay? Now, moving to the next. Inside the food vacuole, complex food substances are broken down into simpler ones. Okay, so the complex food substances are broken down into simpler ones. This is what we call intracellular digestion. Okay, that is inside the cell digestion process is taking place. Okay, so this is what we call intracellular digestion. Inside the cell, the digestion process is taking place. Complex food substances are broken down into simpler ones inside food vacuole. Then these simpler ones diffuse into the cytoplasm. Okay, that is what we call absorption. Okay, if the simpler nutrients are diffused into cytoplasm, then that step is called absorption. The remaining undigested material is moved to the surface of the cell and thrown out. This is what we call adsorption. Okay, so this is the undigested material is moved to the surface of the cell and thrown out. So the waste materials are thrown out of the cell and the process is called adsorption. So this is all about the holozoic nutrition seen in amoeba. Okay, now moving to the next. In paramecium, which is also a unicellular organism, the cell has a definite shape. Okay, food is taken in at a specific spot. Okay, food is moved to the spot by the movement of cilia. These are tiny hair-like structures. So the movement of cilia is moving the food material to a specific spot from which the food enters into the paramecium body. Okay, and the cilia covers the entire surface of the cell where the food is ingested. Okay, so this specific spot, okay, at which the food is ingested, it is called cytostome. And dear students, cytostome can also be called as cell mouth. Okay, now cell mouth. Okay, so through this spot, the food is entering into the paramecium body, and in this process, okay, now cilia are playing important role. If we see here in the diagram, you will understand better. Okay, see, these are the different food materials. These are the different food materials. Okay, and here these are the cilia. Okay, so these are the cilia of paramecium. So these cilia are present all over the body surface. Okay, when the cilia move, the food particles are reaching the specific spot. The specific spot, okay, it is called cytostome. Okay, oral groove, you can also call it oral groove. Okay, it is like a cell mouth. Okay, the food material enters inside through this specific spot. This is called oral groove. Okay, or cell mouth or cytostome. Okay, and after entering inside, the process here also in paramecium, the holozoic nutrition is seen. As I discussed earlier, the mode of nutrition in amoeba is same as the mode of nutrition in paramecium, and this mode is called holozoic nutrition. The food material is ingested and that food is digested inside the cell. That is intracellular digestion take place, and after that the undigested materials, waste, are excreted out again from specific spot that is called anal pore. Okay, now so this is anal pore present here. So from this side, unwanted materials, waste, are released out of the body. So this is how holozoic nutrition is found in paramecium. So intake of food is ingestion, then a food vacuole is formed inside, and inside the food vacuole the food is digested, then after that it is transferred into the cytoplasm, and then it is utilized. Undigested material is removed out of the cell through this anal spot. Okay, so this is called cytopyge. This is also called cytopyge, anal spot, from which the wastes are released out of the cell. So this is about nutrition in paramecium. Okay, so this is all about today's topic. If you are new to my channel, subscribe for more videos. If you liked it, share it with your friends. I'll be back with more videos. Have a great day. Thank you all.